Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will be making a dashiki shirt, which can also be worn as a dress. If you want all that thigh meat out, go ahead girl, do what you do. For fabric suggestions, please check out my blog.
Okay, for your tutorial, you're going to need a panel of dashiki fabric. You're going to need half of a yard of a coordinating fabric that matches the inside circle of the dashiki. You will need some coordinating thread, one to go with the neck part, and then one to go with the main color of your dashiki. You will also need a seam ripper. You'll need a pencil, a fabric marking tool, some sewing pins. You'll need a ruler, so you can, preferably a yardstick, but if you don't have one, a ruler. You'll need a piece of paper. You'll need some paper scissors and fabric scissors. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, first we're gonna start off by hemming the two shorter sides of our dashiki. All right, using this as your fold line, go ahead and turn that in and take your iron and press. And you'll just do that the whole entire way. Using that line as your guide, fold and press. The top and the bottom, they are raw edges. What I like to do for the top and bottom of my dashiki is once it's pressed out, open it up, okay, then turn it in, fold it in, and press. So when you get ready to sew, now you have a nice clean finish. So I do that for the top and bottom part of my dashiki. All right, now we're going to hem the two long edges. Okay, similar to the other edges, we want to use this line as our guide. So what you want to do is turn your fabric up and right on that line, press it out. All right, and because this is a finished edge, there will be no fraying, so we don't have to turn it in again. Okay, go ahead and do that. Press, so you're gonna fold and press the rest of the way. All right, once you have all sides pressed out, we're going to flip it over and we're going to do a top stitch to hem our dashiki. Let's go ahead and go to our machine. All right, I have the edge of my fabric lined up with the edge of the presser foot. So now we're going to work on the neck area of our dashiki. So what I like to do is cut along this portion here. But if you feel like that's not big enough for you, maybe you want to bring yours out and cut along this perimeter. Or maybe you're like, I need more space than that, Montoya. So you might want to cut along this area here. All right, so I'm gonna cut out my circle and then we'll, yeah.
Now that it's cut out, we're going to pick up our garment and we're going to fold it in half. And when you're folding it in half, make sure that it is lined up nice and even. So right along the neck hole, make sure it's nice and even. Go ahead and grab your blank piece of paper. And we're going to fold the dashiki once again. We'll fold it in half. And go ahead and adjust as needed, making sure everything is nice and neat. And make sure you really spend time on this part. I had to redo my neck hole area because I did not fold it correctly. All right, now that it's nice and even, you see me still adjusting. Grab your paper and slip it right under. And go ahead and grab your pencil now and just go ahead and trace the outline of that neck portion. Okay, so now we want to extend our neck piece. So grab your ruler and we are going to measure down 2 inches and make a dot all the way around. So I'm measuring over 2 inches all the way around. And everyone, I do apologize in advance for all the blur during this portion of the tutorial. So I'm just going back in and adding an extra dot there. Now you want to go ahead and connect all of your dots. All right, now go ahead and grab your ruler. We're going to close up the end. And down here, we're going to measure over 1 inch and make a mark. And then in between that mark, go ahead and erase that because we're going to draw a yoke there coming up. So next we need to measure down how far we want our yoke to go. I want mine to be about 5 inches. The V part right in the middle where the dashiki will rest. And I'm adding 1.5 inches for seam allowance. So I'm taking my ruler and I'm measuring down 6.5 inches for my yoke. Then that where that we made that 1 inch marking, we're just going to continue just drawing a little curve. Nothing fancy. Then what we need to do is add 1/2 inch seam allowance. So I'm taking my ruler and I'm just extending out 1/2 inch from the end. And I'm just going to close that up. And now I'm just going to go ahead and trace over this with my Sharpie. And lastly, I'm just going to erase any little extra and I'm going to write fold right here because we will be cutting this piece out on the fold.
All right, now go ahead and grab your yoke piece and go ahead and lay out your 1/2 yard piece. What you want to do is take one side and you want to fold it over, all right? So now we have one side folded over. Take your piece and we're gonna cut 2 of these. So this line is lined up with the fold of the fabric. You're going to cut it out once, and then cut it out a second time. So now you should have two. So you can choose one of them that you want to cut, because we'll be using one for the front and one for the back. So I'm gonna cut this one for my back. Okay, so now we have one front piece and this is the back neck piece. So what you wanna do is open up the front one. And you want to take the back piece, and we're going to do a stitch. We're going to do a stitch along here and along here. So I'm gonna just... All right, go ahead and grab your yoke neck and make sure that your dashiki is the right side, the front part. So you want to take the part of the yoke that has the long edge, and you want to put the right side of the yoke to the right side of the fabric, and you want to line that up. Pin in place. And to hold this yoke down, I'm going to take some additional pins. Alright, sorry, for my neck yoke, what I did was I marked off, I made a mark here for the inch. This is an inch of seam allowance, so I used my ruler and I marked down 1 inch. Then I used the center fold line, and we want like a real tight gap when doing this. So I took my ruler and I made one line going out a slant, and then I made another line. So I'm going to stitch along those lines.
Okay, now go ahead and pin the rest of the neck yoke around the neck area of your dashiki. So making sure that it's nice and lined up and pinning where necessary. All right, so I'm going to be doing, we're going to do 5/8. We're going to do 5/8 of a seam allowance, a 1/2 inch seam allowance. When we get here, we're going to sew down on this line. Leave our needle, come back up, and sew on this line. Okay, so I'm starting at one of the side seams of the yoke and the neckline. So I'm just lowering my needle, back stitching, and I'm going to start sewing all the way around.
into my line. So I'm going to raise up my presser foot. I'm going to turn it. Alright, and I'm going to sew down the first line. Leave my needle there, turn my fabric, now I'm going to sew back up this line. You don't want to go all the way to the end. Leave yourself some space because we're getting ready to turn it and keep doing our. So I'm going to raise it. I'm going to turn it. And I'm going to go right back to my half an inch seam allowance. Alright, next we're going to take our scissors and we're going to cut right in between our stitches. Alright, you're going to cut all the way down and make sure you do not cut the stitches down at the bottom. Just get close enough. Next, we want to cut off the corners here so that when we turn it, it has a nice pointy end. So just go ahead and cut both sides. I should have used a different color thread so you can see where the corner is. All right, so now go ahead and we're going to take it to our iron and we're going to press this collar flat just like this, how I have it. Go ahead and press it out just like that. All right, so now we are going to cut some little notches in the seam allowance of the collar. This is going to help us when we get ready to turn it to the inside. It won't be so, it'll help the collar to lay flat. So go ahead and do that all the way around your collar area. All right, so this is our neckline now, all pressed out. We're going to do a top stitch. So we're going to do a top stitch along the edge, come down, needle here, and come back up and stitch all the way around. and lay out your dashiki. I have it folded in half at the top. And you're gonna need your ruler, your marking tool, and some pins. All right, so when you have yours laid out, mine, it really wasn't that even. So I had to put some pins in it at the bottom. I went ahead and put some pins just so to hold it in place, to hold this bottom edge in place to make sure it's lined up. So I did that, okay? So now we need to mark our stitching lines on the side. Okay, you wanna take your weight, your hip measurement, and you want to add 2 inches. Then you want to take this number and you want to divide it by 4. All right, so mine is 10.5, so I'm going to use that measurement to measure over. All right, working with the center point of our dashiki, you're going to take that measurement. So mine was 10.5, so I'm lining up the middle with 10.5. Yeah, I'm lining up this middle point with 10.5 on my ruler. Take my marking utensil. And I'm going to keep marking. So now I'm here at this next point in the center, lining up 10.5. Okay, I'm keep going a little bit. I'm gonna match this center point here. Line it up with 10.5. Mark that. Okay, I'm gonna use this point here. Line it up with 10.5. And mark that. For down here, I'm gonna kind of gauge. All right, and in order to determine where our line should stop, you want to measure down from the top. We want to measure down 12 inches. So I'm gonna start at the top, and 12 inches stops at about there. I'll do the same thing on this side. Alright, so now I'm going to make a line all the way down. So I'm actually grab my yardstick. So I'm gonna find 10.5. Alright, so from my 12 inch point, I'm going to mark all the way down. Okay, so now we're going to stitch right on top of these white lines. And what I like to do is, to keep my fabric in place, I like to take some pins and just kind of place them just so when I get ready to sew, my fabric doesn't shift. All right, I went ahead and switched over to black thread because it matches my black here. So starting at the end of my white line mark, right on top of that white line. All right, everyone, this concludes the tutorial. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for future tutorials. And also check out my blog and other social media outlets for more pictures and other DIY projects. And comment below if you have any questions. Until next time, doses.